Started, but before we get the music popping, we want to have one of the funnest female comedians here in The Rock doing her thing.
So
she's been rocking out for a minute.
Come on.
She is hilarious.
Yes,
and she reminds me of my girl Juicy from the Little Women of Atlanta.
You better say it. Listen, oh, she's about to get you. She's so beautiful. She is so beautiful. She gonna get him.
Give it up for my girl, Tina Marie 2.0. Give it up.
Come on and start clapping for her. Thank you. What? Come on.
Hey, Tina, when you gonna stop playing? Damn, cheat, that could be a fantasy. I can tell you got beat energy. It ain't too many of them that can handle me, but I might let you.
How everybody doing tonight? Everybody came, because I'm a Gemini, and that rain had me all fucked up. And let me first start by saying I'm working on my cussing, and I might need y'all help. But I was feeling a little dreary, and you know what? My black ebony queens, I got to get them homage first, honey. Y'all representing. I was standing back there like, oh, he's saying everybody motherfucking name but mine. I almost came out there like Tony. Hello, I'm right there at the step, motherfucker. But my girls, my black ebony queens, they came and showed up and showed out. I call them my black ebony queens because names mean a lot. And we can make up later if you're mad about it. That's just what it is. You know, y'all asses, excuse me. Tony, I did my first open mic at that spot at the French Quarter. And I told a Popeyes joke, and I told about the little boy. The little boy was 6 feet tall, and he always called me Frogger. And I saw him after I caught myself getting fined before I had two kids in the corner store. I'm by the freezer, he by the cash register, yelling out Frogger. I said his name last time. I got a lot of hits on that video. Somebody said, ain't that your Alcindor? Yeah, your big ass still had a book bag on your back. I don't know if that bitch was still in school or had a gun. I don't know these days. Ain't no telling. Guess what? I don't know why people like to leave their dogs out. Put your goddamn dogs up. Put your goddamn dogs up. Y'all know who to go. Put your goddamn dogs up. Them motherfuckers chased me all around the car, bag full of groceries and shit. I start throwing chicken at they motherfucking ass. These motherfuckers got to leave me. I'm like, dogs, like, I got chased by one 20 years ago on crack. Can you imagine a crackhead running from a dog? Shit. I think I was selling some sheets by 5 o'clock in the morning. Them sheets was muddy as a motherfucker, but guess what? That dog didn't catch me. It's a pit bull. I was bragging about that shit. I fuck around and pit bull can't catch me. Then about a year ago, I got chased by a goddamn Great Dane. He about that tall. That bitch ain't catch me either. So when I tell you I made a Teflon and I'm a child of God at the same time, we gonna keep it moving, y'all. Whispers and M&Q Productions. Let's give it up for them one time, okay? The first annual Black Ebony Harvest Fest. I love uplifting women. Love it. I'm a Gemini. I think I'm the whole shit. Not part of the shit, the whole shit. So we gonna give it up for Jay Whispers. And you know what? I told y'all my first open mic was at the French Quarter. And I also told y'all names mean a lot. I think Grand Tone forgot what the hell happened to him the first time he called me Lil Juicy. That was my first open mic. I had to drink so much. But names mean a lot. So let me tell you, Tina Marie 2.0, that mean a lot to me. Because she is a legend. Tina Marie is definitely a legend. And I believe I'm one too in my own right. I just ain't got the money and shit. I don't know what the... Anybody ever heard of that? Not y'all. No. It's people that say and do stupid shit. For real, you have to talk about that shit. Because if you don't, you'll be out here going crazy. Because I don't know if the rest of y'all know, but peace ain't free. They say peace of mind is free. Shit, you got to fight like a motherfucker to keep some peace of mind. And she's very loving, loving young lady. But about a year ago, she said, y'all got to pay attention now, because this is some PTSD for that ass. About a year ago, she said, I want to start kissing when I see y'all. Life too short. Let's not just hug, let's kiss. It threw me off because it was right in the middle of the motherfucking corona, bitch. I ain't kissing you, my mama, my granddaddy. I ain't kissing no motherfucker body. So she wanted to kiss and shit. So I said, don't do it, bitch. So last Christmas, she was helping again. Happy go save a hoe, bitch. She helping do Christmas baskets. And another friend of ours gave her $500 for Christmas. She was happier than a motherfucker. She was, shut up. She was so damn happy, she grabbed our other friend and kissed her right in the motherfucking mouth. Bitch called me next week with the goddamn coronavirus. I said, bitch, told you about that motherfucker kissing them deadly ass kisses. But this bitch still wanna kiss. I said, you know what, bitch? I'm not doing that. I'm gonna say hi. I'm not doing that. So our same friend took her out to dinner a couple weeks ago. Spent about $300 on the goddamn food and drink. She was so happy. Guess what she did, y'all? Big ass kiss. Not a bit scared. She got some shit called the dingo virus. What the fuck is a dingo virus? Only motherfucking dingo I want, bitch, is a man dingo. I have a niece that we love to go out. And about 10 years ago, we was in S&T's. Don't act like y'all don't go to S&T's when she leave you. So I couldn't find my phone. So I'm looking all over for my phone. I said, call my phone, niece. Her aunt started busting out laughing. I said, what the fuck's so funny? She said, nothing. I said, call my phone. Quit playing. She's still laughing. She about to pee on herself. She laughing so hard. So I said, what in the fuck is so funny? She said, she got you on your phone on Popeyes. Popeyes? Bitch, you better change that right now. Right now.
We're dedicated to the mental illness that is preying our cities and also in our families. You know, we have to pay attention to these things that happen. You know, by being in the health field, it makes a big difference and you see a lot of things, you know. So I just want to say to everyone, I appreciate you guys for coming out. I couldn't do this without you. Also to the chef back there. Man, how was the food? I just want to know. Ooh, how was the food? The food is always a review because you can go to any event and it can be good, but when you go to that table, be like, now I'm good. So as long as you guys enjoy the food, everything was good. I'm blessed to have you here. Thank you very much. Jay Whispers Entertainment and M&Q Production. We love you.